Nico Anna Jean here. Hi, everyone. I am here to talk about narcissistic parents and how they can actually be blocking your business success, whether or not they might be in your life currently, whether you might have modified or no contact with them, or whether maybe you have a parent in your life that you suspect has some narcissistic traits, or you haven't even defined them as narcissistic. However, if you have a parent in your life that is currently drawing on a lot of your energy, your time, your attention, through whether it might be lots of drama or crisis, or just lots of difficulty, lots of like, you know, difficulties in interacting with and communicating and dealing with this particular parent, this could be defined as narcissistic. It doesn't mean that your parent has a narcissistic personality disorder, but it could. And it also has to do with those of you who had a narcissistic parent. Maybe they're not even in your life anymore. Maybe they've passed on even. However, you've internalized something in your system in which part of you is still interacting with that parent on a level. And that's usually the inner child part. And this is actually causing a block. This is causing a stuckness in your movement forward. So I want to talk a little bit more about this because this stuff is so subtle, you guys. I mean, I know there's a lot of stuff out there online about narcissism. And I think it's really helpful to be able to research and learn about narcissistic personality disorder and, you know, learning about the traits and the different expressions of narcissistic personalities. And I think that this is an important stage, and I've said this before. However, at some point, we really have to start shifting our focus from the research mode and onto ourselves. And we kind of have to sometimes set aside the question of, is my whoever really a narcissist, whoever that is in your life? Because of the fact that if you think you need to decide if you're right or not about it before you can make changes or move forward on creating different levels of contact or modifying contact with this person in your life, then I promise you that you're going to just delay. You're going to delay the inevitable, which is at some point you're going to realize that no matter what, these behaviors are stopping you or creating problems in your life or challenging you. This is a toxic relationship and unhealthy behaviors happening. And these behaviors are like setting you up to be in a pattern that is really unhealthy and blocking you in your energy overall. So what I'm saying to you is that there are these just really subtleties in the narcissistic dynamic in your relationship with a parent in particular that can really stop you when you are trying to move forward in your business, whether maybe you're just starting or whether you're in a phase, you know, you've been doing it for a while, but you're in a phase or maybe you've plateaued or you're trying something new, or you're stepping out maybe and becoming more, trying to become more visible, you know, trying to scale your business, or even maybe change, do something different, you know, hit it from one thing to another. So if you think about the fact that a narcissist, they're very competitive and that they need to be superior all the time. They need to be right. That's a very common, you all know that if you're watching this, you probably know that. That's a common narcissistic trait. What I want to say to you is that if you have a narcissistic parent, why do you think it's going to be any different with you? You know, maybe this particular parent you're thinking of, they may not express as highly competitive on the surface. Like it's not an obvious competition. Or and maybe even it's not an obvious superiority, which, you know, this is called kind of the covert side, is that it's what you can't see. It's what you don't see. It's not this overt expression of narcissism, but it's just this covert expression that I'm kind of talking about today, because it's so hard to detect. And we're so used to it. We're so used to it as just like being normal, even though our body's telling us all the time, this is off, this is wrong. But our inner child doesn't really want to see the truth of how off it is, or how wrong it feels, or even how predatory it even feels. You know, there's a predatory dynamic in a narcissistic relationship, and narcissists are always the predator, and they're dependent, call it. The person they get supply from is prey. I'm just going to say it like that's pretty much what it is. That's what it comes down to in really simple terms. And so it's difficult for people who maybe have been in a covert narcissistic relationship with a covert expression, an apparent that has a very, you know, they're always showing up covert most of the time, to be able to detect this sort of predatory dynamic, but you can feel it and it's always there. So it's just this kind of a low level, like, you know, always kind of needing to be the one that knows, always just sort of like backhanded compliments, you know, like if you ever get praise from this parent, it's usually followed up with some kind of like taking ownership of your success anyway. So it's very subversive. You know, and then there's this feeling too, in which, you know, the parent that's like this typically doesn't want to be outdone. They don't want to be outshined. And so even if it's not obvious, there'll be this sort of feeling between you and the parent, like you don't really want to outdo them or look smarter or know something about things that they don't know about. Like, you know how everyone has like an area of expertise. You know, you can't know everything about everything all the time, but narcissists think they do. And they need to think they do. So it's really difficult when you're an adult to then just have like a ownership of a part of your life in which maybe you're an expert at your field of expertise, you know, and then you're trying to go out into the world and own this. And even if your narcissistic parent isn't directly trying to compete with you, your inner child is feeling really uncomfortable about this because putting yourself out there as an expert to the world, or, you know, wherever, it doesn't have to be the whole world, but just at all, is really threatening to the inner child. The inner child doesn't want to outdo the narcissistic parent because they know there's going to be punishment. They know that, you know, it's not going to go well. So it's not safe. It's not safe to outdo or outshine the narcissistic parent, or even sometimes it could be a narcissistic sibling. You know, there could be a dynamic in a family in which a sibling got a lot of attention, and then as you grow up, this adult sibling, you know, is in this, you're in this dynamic where it's not safe to outshine that sibling for some reason. Whether the sibling themselves is a narcissist or not doesn't matter, because if there was narcissism in the family system, then there wasn't a healthy dynamic. So probably there was a narcissistic parent somewhere in there, and then there was a sibling that ended up like sucking all the energy from the whole family and in a drama triangle with the parents, which is, you know, that's a whole other video, you guys. So what I'm saying to you is that what I'm saying to you is that some of you are out there and, oh my gosh, I want you to know so bad this information, but I want you to know that like that things you think are stopping you from really having the success you want in your business, like going out there and putting yourself out there, getting clients, getting customers, you know, receiving income for the beautiful work that you do, and being able to support yourself and your family and being abundant. The reason that that's not happening for you is not because you don't have the right marketing strategy, or you don't know enough, or you don't have a team, or whatever reason you think it is. It's truly coming from an internal part of you that's stopping you. And it feels real. It feels like this, you know, it just feels horrible and frustrating until you can become aware of where it's coming from. And you have to learn to make the adjustments in that dynamic with that parent, whether it's in your actual life or it's internal. And it always starts internally. But like I said, this could be someone who isn't even in your life anymore, but you're playing out the dynamic internally. So I know I just blasted you with like a lot of information all at once right there. I hope that it's helpful to you. Listen, I've got a mastermind group where this is the stuff we do. This is the work we do in the HeartShine EFT Mastermind, you guys. If you think that you might be ready to really get some do, go deep and find out where the heck am I stuck, and how can I have better boundaries with narcissistic or toxic people in my life? How the heck do I reparent my inner child so I can start to heal and I can start to really show up like as my authentic self and truly shine and be able to be a beneficial presence in the world and receive abundance. If you're ready for that, then I definitely want to talk with you about joining the mastermind. Just look below for the information below this video. There's lots of links you can click. You can book a chat with me, and you can go to my website and check out some of my free resources. Okay, everyone, take care. May you be at ease and know joy. Bye-bye.